We call your attention to the book of St. John, the 20th chapter, the 24th through the 29th verses. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, We've seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days again his disciples were within, and Thomas within. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hand. And reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side. And be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen and yet believe in. Doubting Thomas. Doubting Thomas. The passage that I have read in your hearing tonight deal with one of the post-resurrection incidents. If you can call upon your knowledge of history and upon your powers of imagination, you could picture the hostile world in which these followers of Jesus found themselves. The Jewish hierarchy had put their leader to death. He had been tried and condemned by the Jewish church, by the Roman courts, and he had been nailed to a tree while they looked on. They had seen him drop his head after a terrible experience during the night of trial, scourging and crucifixion that ended on Friday evening about 3 o'clock. They heard him say after that terrible night, it is finished. You know how they must have felt when they had chosen to follow him, when they had accepted him as their Messiah, the anointed of God. And now the man whom they had called the Son of God was now dead and apparently disgraced. And of course, you know how they must have felt. Some of them said, well, I'm going back to fishing. I'm going back to my old job. I'm going back to my old vocation. It seems that we made a mistake. I believe Peter made the suggestion, and the others followed his lead. Thomas, who was of the scientific turn of mind, heard some rumors. The women had said that they had seen him and that he was alive. Others said that they were en route to Emmaus. And he joined them and talked with them. And while he talked, their hearts burned. Some of the rest of them reported that they had seen. Lately, it was said that in their secret gathering place in Jerusalem to avoid the police and to avoid arrest and embarrassment, that he had come into their meeting. But Thomas said, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. Obviously, you're being swept by rumors or you're suffering from hallucinations. Nobody has ever died as I saw that man die and come back again. I was looking at them when they hung him to the tree. I was looking at them when they nailed his hands and his feet. I was looking when the soldier thrust a sword into his side. And I heard him when he dropped his head say, it is finished. And I saw them take him down from the cross and lay him in Joseph's tomb. I know he's dead. Now there's only one way that you can ever tell me anything different, and that is I'll have to see. And I'm not going to trust that. He is going to have to show me his hand and let me see the nail prints in his hand. He will have to let me look at his side, and then I will have to examine his side for myself. I must satisfy the sense of seeing and of feeling before I shall be convinced. I don't believe that he's alive. Now, Thomas, called Didymus, which means the twin, has received a great deal of ridicule from the Christian world about his doubting position. But you know, you must give some respect to people who want to know, to people who are not satisfied with hearsay. You must give some respect to people who want to base their faith upon as much knowledge as they can acquire. You see, superstition, rumor, and hearsay is not a sufficient foundation for faith. I know that faith transcends knowledge. But you get all the knowledge you can get before you stop. For you see, Thomas was moving on fact. And you see, fact can carry you just so far. It was a fact that Jesus was put to death, that he was hanged to a tree. It was a fact that he dropped his head and died and declared, it is finished. Yes, this was a fact. Yes, sir. It was a fact that they took him down and laid him in a tomb. Yes, all of this was fact. But that is as far as fact could go. This is the reason that Thomas couldn't go any further. Because he was proceeding on the basis of fact. You understand what I'm talking about? His whole operation was based upon empiricism. investigation and what one can find out. But you see, faith, you understand what I mean? Goes on beyond the grave. I don't believe you know what I'm talking about. Faith doesn't stop at the grave. Faith didn't stop when he said it was finished. Faith didn't stop when they rolled the tomb to the door, when they rolled the stone to the tomb. And faith didn't stop when the governor's seal was placed thereon. For you see, faith goes beyond what I can see and what I know. I can't prove God, and you don't have to prove God. Somebody said, "You haven't seen God, or you haven't seen heaven, and all that kind of thing. That doesn't mean anything." So who's been there? That doesn't mean anything. What you cannot prove, what you cannot see, is no argument against its existence. You can't see electricity, but God knows it exists. You can't see energy, but take all the energy out of this room tonight, and all of us would be dead shortly. Many of the forces of the universe, you can't prove them, you can't see them, you can't touch them, but they do exist. They are realities. I don't believe you know what I'm talking about. But Thomas was like many of you that are listening to me tonight. He wanted to base his faith totally upon fact. Totally upon faith. Or rather upon fact. But you see, faith moves out beyond what I can touch, beyond what I can see, beyond sometimes what I can hear, and even beyond what I can investigate. I don't know where God is, but I believe he liveth. I don't know anything about how he raised his son. I'm not concerned about whether it was bodily or spiritual. I believe that Jesus liveth tonight. I believe that he is a living reality. He is a transforming influence in this old world of ours.